Major developments tonight out of Flint, Michigan.
Lead in the water supply.
Yeah, that's in our daughter's body.
Go to the deadly Ebola outbreak.
Our lead story here tonight was the news of the first diagnosed case of Ebola in the U.S.
Ebola seems to be winning this battle.
Many of the pipelines we have in the U.S. still contain lead. Problem is, when the water is transported over the pipelines, some of the contamination can occur in the distribution system. That's exactly what we have seen in the city of Flint. In that case, if you don't have a real-time sensor to monitor the water quality, then our human being will become the sensors, which is the last thing you wanted to see. Many of the children have uptaken this lead and accumulated the lead in their body. And this is an irreversible process and will have a consequence for the rest of their life.
There's really no affordable sensor out there today to measure heavy metal or biological contamination. Junhong's technology appears to be a way that we can drive the cost of the sensor down so that we can actually make it affordable to every user to immediately know when they open up their spigot that the water that they're drawing is free of contamination that can be harmful.
We really wanted to avoid this and many other catastrophes, you know, in our society by delivering a technology that can enable us to monitor these contamination events in real time anywhere you want.
The earlier you identify a patient with Ebola, the lower the amount of virus that's in their system. So by early diagnosis, you are actually protecting the rest of the local population from acquiring the disease. And that's pretty much where it intersected with the amazing technology that Dr. Chen is developing to be able to develop rapid, sensitive, and low-cost diagnostics.
What we're developing is something that can quickly detect in our body fluids, you know, blood, urine, etc. We are hoping to be able to detect very low concentrations of the Ebola agents so that we can diagnose the Ebola virus as early as possible so that there's a better treatment or to avoid larger scale catastrophes.
The kinds of things we can do for each other, Dr. Chen's group and myself, is to look at the same problem from slightly different perspectives. And that's one of the great things about working in teams with collaborations, interdisciplinary groups.
We're aiming at some of the larger scale societal problems to address. That's what we should be doing because, you know, some of the easy problems have been solved. But what's left are the hard problems and more difficult problems. But once solved, those solutions can have a significant impact on our society and save people's lives, you know, at larger scale to avoid, you know, the complications related to all these diseases. We are all excited about, you know, what we can make and what we can contribute.